Good morning. We have already learned about conservation of mechanical energy.
Flippin' physics.
Remind me, Billy, when can we use the conservation of mechanical energy equation?
I actually don't remember.
Mechanical energy is conserved when there's no work done by friction and...
There is no work done by the force applied.
Thank you.
Now we are going to discuss how to solve problems with a work done by friction. We will leave problems with a work done by force applied for later. When the work done by the force applied in an object is equal to zero, the work done by friction is equal to the change in mechanical energy. But what is the equation for the work done by friction?
Well, work is the force doing the work, which in this case is the force of friction, times the displacement of the object, times the cosine of the angle between the force and the displacement.
Remember to use the magnitude of the force and the magnitude of the displacement, because it is the cosine of the angle that determines if the work is positive or negative.
And Bobby, what equation does delta ME, or the change in mechanical energy, work out to be?
I'm not sure what you mean by equation.
You know, change in time, change in velocity.
Change in position, change in displacement.
But change in position is displacement. There is no such thing as change in displacement.
Yeah.
Okay, change in means final minus initial, so change in mechanical energy equals mechanical energy final minus mechanical energy initial.
Therefore, the equation we use when the work done on an object by the force applied is equal to zero, and there's work done by the force of friction on an object, is the force of friction times the displacement times the cosine of theta is equal to mechanical energy final minus mechanical energy initial. Remind me, Bo, what are the three things I asked you to remember about the direction of the force of friction?
The force of friction is always parallel to the surfaces, opposes sliding motion, and is independent of the direction of the force applied.
And the angle in the work due to friction equation is the angle between the direction of the force of friction and the direction of the displacement of the object. Therefore, the angle theta in your work due to friction equation is always 180 degrees.
That makes sense. If an object is sliding to the left, the force of friction is to the right, and the displacement of the object is to the left. Therefore, the angle between the direction of the force of friction and the direction of the displacement is 180 degrees.
And if the object is moving to the right, the force of friction points left, and the displacement of the object points right, and the angle between the force of friction and the displacement is still 180 degrees. Sure, I got it.
I want my $2.
Now, I do want to be careful with this always, because it actually isn't quite always true. There are a few examples where the force of friction is actually in the same direction the object is moving. One example is if a hockey puck is on top of a block of wood. As we pull the block to the right, the hockey puck is accelerated to the right by the force of friction. In this case, the force of friction acting on the hockey puck and the displacement of the hockey puck are both in the same direction. Therefore, the angle in the work due to friction equation actually works out to be 0 degrees. Now, this is a bit of an unusual situation, however, I did want to make sure that I mentioned it, because as you get further into your physics careers, it will come up more and more often. Now let's take a look at what happens to our work due to friction equation if the work due to friction is equal to zero. If the work done by the force of friction is equal to zero, that means zero equals the change in mechanical energy, which means zero is equal to mechanical energy final minus mechanical energy initial. Adding mechanical energy initial to both sides gives us mechanical energy initial equals mechanical energy final, or conservation of mechanical energy. Which means conservation of mechanical energy is just a special case of the work due to friction equation equals change in mechanical energy, where the work done by friction is equal to zero. Which means, class, when we use the work done by friction equals change in mechanical energy equation, we need to
clearly identify the locations of our initial and final points,
and identify the location of the horizontal zero line.
Absolutely. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.